name is Colbert Mashile. I've studied art at the Art Foundation in Johannesburg, and then from there I went to do my degree at Wits. And then I've been, you know, since I graduated, I've been practicing as a professional artist ever since. My upbringing played a big role in the way I perceive the world, you know, because when I grew up in the rural area, when I was young, there was no electricity. It was like dark, you know, when the night comes, it's really dark. And then the folklore, the stories that elderly people told us were so real. I mean, they were so ingrained in us. We saw the world according to them, you know. There was no other way. There was no way of interacting with anything. There were no books. There was no way of going to urban areas and start to see life differently. So I was in the rural areas until I passed my matric. So you can imagine how my thoughts, my worldview was formed by my surroundings. So I started to explore it. I wanted to capture all that I went through, the weight of it, you know, sometimes there are certain feelings that we have but that we don't really talk about. Although it was misinterpreted in the media as if I am against initiation, you know, it's not about that really. It's about trying to find something that's profound, that's really meaningful to me in a way. So I dealt with it, with the imagery, but it was not narrative per se. It was just fragments of ideas that I used, like maybe imagery relating to the songs, the poems, the totems and other things, you know. I tried to conceptualize those things, I tried to put them in a visual form. It's sort of like things that I have to deal with on a daily basis. I know it was during times of the dying days of apartheid and all artists were sort of concerned with dealing with the social issues. But for me, I wanted something personal that resonates deep with me. Because the darkness at night means something to me. It doesn't mean anything to anybody. Let's say in the city, you know, the dark of the night might mean, you know, I'll be mugged or things like that. For me, it's like about imagining certain creatures that exist at night, you know. And then I create those kind of myths because I've never seen them. That the night harbors witches, the night harbors unforeseen things. I mean, there are certain kind of fears that you grow up with. You learn to tolerate them as you grow up, but you create certain barriers in your life. I don't do this because this is going to happen, I don't do this. Although it's all, I can't say superstition, because some are life lessons really. And then people have survived through the ages using that kind of education, teaching young people how to view the world and what's going to befall them if this happens, if that happens. As artists, I think it's our duty to observe the world and you know, and record it from day to day. As an artist, having the opportunity to teach and pass on your skills, the way of thinking on the two young people is very, very important. But for now, I'm concentrating really on working so much on the wider scale in terms of socio-political. My work was very psychological in a way. But now, although the stories would always be difficult to read at one go, at a glance, but I see my work, maybe it's because of my age and also because of the apparent things that are happening in our country. It's very hard for me to go back to what I've been doing before, sort of like a reclusive, deep thoughts. I think now it's opening up, opening the book for a lot of people to read, you know. Through what I'm doing, what I'm working on. I'm having a show coming on at Seka in end of January next year. So the works that I'm working on now are really mostly about it, socio-political, somewhat still enclosed a bit. The narrative is sort of like still hidden, but it's basically mostly about that.